I'm Lina Fruzzetti, an anthropologist. I've been teaching at Brown for, I would say, since 1975. This is the first job. And I've been working before that in India doing research for about 5 or 6 years. And so over the years and doing all this research, I thought one of the things to do was to move from text, writing books, to doing an actual ethnographic film about a community that one knows very well. So could only do it because, you know, I sort of know already something about the society, how women interact in their everyday and so on. And so one of the first film that both Akush and I thought, my husband and I decided to do together, was Seed and Earth, which is about male and female relationship, without actually calling it male and female, but it's called Seed and Earth, because women are seen as the earth and men are the seed. You know, you plant the seed, and if the seed is good, it will take. Otherwise, you know, the seed has to be replanted, you know, replanted and so on. And that's how they see themselves, women begetting the seed of man, produce a child, and the child is of man. But women's contribution to the child would be more in terms of breastfeeding the child. And the placenta, which is considered to be femaleness, goes back into the earth. So from that kind of accumulated knowledge, we were able to successfully do the first film, which is Seed and Earth, and then moved on to other films, returned to Africa, but returned back to India again, because I think it's India that really lends itself to this array of ideas that you can now sort of think of doing it on film, putting it on film. So again, I went back to India and decided to look not at traditional anthropology in terms of film, but to look at something new. What else is going on? One of the questions that I faced was violence, domestic violence, victimization of women, the question of aborting of female fetuses, and lack of illiteracy rates among young girls in contrast to men, to boys. So we thought, and somebody told us, you know, there is this community that actually paints scrolls that describes some of these issues that I began to be interested in. And I said, well, maybe we should. So we spent time with this community in Naya. And the community itself is called the Patuas, which means painters of scrolls. So we went and started this film on the scroll painters without really thinking it's going to be about men or women. After the first year, it became clear that the attention is going to be on women. We found them much more informative about what they're doing. They were not just painting random topics. They were painting topics that really matter to them. Some of the strong ones that I remember is the question of domestic violence and victimization of women. Another was what happens to a woman when she gives birth to a child, to a female baby, you know, and how they ill-treat a woman because she's done that and not given a male child. So with all that in mind, we realized that when we returned back for some more shoot of this film, that we were really more centered on women, how they articulate what they paint. Mm-hmm. And they came out as extremely powerful about the presentation of their subjects, about the songs that they sing. But if you ask them, they say, well, we do that but in the social issues, but we're also interested in the traditional way of painting, which is Hindu gods and goddesses from the Ramayana and the Mahabharata. I would say it's women who came up with scrolls about social issues. It wasn't something that came out of men's thinking about it. And women just joined this tradition of painting for the last 10 to 15 years. But they took off so fast and so strong that they now have over surpassed male painters of the same kind, from the same tradition, to the point where it's becoming an issue now. You know, the men are beginning to resent the success of the women painters. So this, we selected three women out of the 15 women cooperative to come and represent and sort of help us with the premiere of the film. But before doing that, we took the film back to them and said, this film is not completed yet. Look at it and tell us what you think. You say some damaging things here about males, about society. And I said, we can cut that out, and just, because, you know, after all, when I show the film, I don't live here, I live in the U.S., but you are here. And they said, they looked at it, the whole cooperative, and said, keep it as it is. What we say is what we stand for. I mean, I was really, to tell you the truth, here I am, an advocate of women's rights and so on. I was so amazed and surprised by that sort of stand, and say, I'm gonna cry now, but that kind of power that they have about them. I was more worried about them than they were worried about themselves.